Instance names of symbols are very important when working with ActionScript 3.0. They allow you to target specific objects and tell them exactly what to do in your code. To give a practical example of this, imagine you're at an event and it's full of people doing a variety of things, and you yell out, "Hey, stop doing that." If you did that, you wouldn't have much success because either no one would listen or they would all stop in confusion. This is because they don't know, number one, who you're talking to, and number two, what you want them to stop doing. However, if you were to yell something like, "Renee, don't throw that book good away," you would have a greater chance of success. That direction targets someone by name and gives them a specific instruction. Instance names perform the same function. Let's see this in action. In this solar system game that I've created, we have a game where the first page has the solar system title animated in, then we have the directions and have them enter an astronaut's name, and then we have scrambled planets and scrambled labels that they need to put in order from the closest to the sun to the furthest away from the sun. And last, we have the answer screen. Now you'll notice that on the last two pages, I have two of each planet and two of each label. That doesn't mean I have two Saturn movie clips. I actually only have one Saturn movie clip, but I've used it twice. The problem is, if I want to start adding script to this movie clip or in my Flash file so that it targets that movie clip so I can drag and drop it, it's going to become a problem because I have two instances of that movie clip on the stage. So I can't just say, make the movie clip MC Saturn drag and drop, because then that it's going to get confused because it doesn't know which one you mean, which one is the one that you want to drag and drop. So we're going to target this one specifically by giving it an instance name. Instance names can be found in the Properties panel. First, though, you have to make sure you've selected that movie clip on the stage. So when I click this Saturn movie clip, I can call this one Saturn Move. This is the one I want to have the user move. If I go to this page and click on this instance of Saturn, you'll see that it doesn't have an instance name because even though they came from the same movie clip, there are two instances of that movie clip on the stage. So this one, if I wanted to, I can call this Saturn Answer because this is just, they're not going to drag and drop it. It's just the answer of to where it is in the order of planets. Now I can target this specifically with drag and drop ActionScript. If I double click this action script in the code snippets, you'll see that it automatically added the instance name and said, for the object with the instance name of Saturn Move, if the user presses their mouse down, then let them drag it. And then it says on the stage, if there's a mouse up, release it to drop the Saturn Move. So this is generally where I will take this instance name, copy it, and paste it so that we're targeting that one specifically. So that way Flash knows it's not this one that we want to move, it's specifically this instance of that movie clip. Let's see this one more time. I don't have Jupiter on here yet. I have the movie clip Jupiter, and I want one on this screen, and I want another one on this screen. And now that's a super big planet, so technically it's supposed to be a little bit smaller, so it's easier to work with. But when I come back to this screen, for this one, I need to call this one Jupiter Move, and then add my action script. And that'll make sure that you are, in fact, targeting this particular instance of that planet. Now, if you forget to do an instance name, sometimes Flash helps you out with that. If I click on, well, let's click on Neptune, and I can double click drag and drop, and it's going to say this selected symbol requires an instance name. So I'll call this one Neptune Move and click OK. Now all of a sudden you can see that action script, and it used my instance name to target that object specifically. So make sure when you're working in Flash that you are using instance names for all of the things that you want to target with ActionScript. So that can include buttons. If I look here, this button has an instance name of playBTN. And if I look on the ActionScript for that, I'm targeting that instance of that button and have an event listener that when somebody clicks, it's going to go to the next frame. So same thing with all of these. This one has an instance of start button. And when I click here, all of a sudden the ActionScript is referring to that object by its instance name, not by the name it's given in the library or the movie clip name. So if I come over here, you can see my movie clip name for the start button is BTN start. But my instance name, again, is start BTN, and that's what it's referring to. So make sure you have everything that you want to target with the ActionScript. Make sure it has an instance name in order to be successful.